this town has not won a championship in 52 years.
The city of Cleveland has just been yearning for it.
We've been waiting a long time. I'm an old man now.
Delivering a championship means a whole lot more in Cleveland because that pressure is real.
Can the Cavaliers wash away 52 years of heartache?
Our backs were up against the wall and we were down, but not out.
Oh, he throws it down!
I believe.
I know we can win.
I believe.
We have an opportunity to do something special.
Oh, blocked by James!
Let's make history.
I believe.
This is a journey I was preparing for my whole life.
The impossible dream has come true!
Cleveland! This is for you!
The Golden State Warriors take a commanding 3-1 lead.
The Cavaliers were battling history. No team had ever come back from such a daunting deficit at the NBA Finals.
LeBron James and the Cavs now in a big hole as they head back to Oakland.
The desperation was all too familiar. Over 5 decades, Cleveland's professional teams had been denied championship glory in a series of heartbreaking moments that could be readily recited.
The Ernest Byner fumble in the AFC Championship game, to Jose Mason not being able to close out in the World Series, to the Michael Jordan shot heard around the world over Craig Elo.
Jordan to the circle, puts the shot in the air. Good! The game's over, and the Bulls have won.
Here you have this one black cloud that was over us, and each year that was going by, whether it be 47 years or 48 years or whatever, was another opportunity for the national media to put out the reel with all the different near misses that we had.
If the 2016 Cavaliers were to avoid becoming another reminder of the city's unfulfilled pursuit of a title, they'd have to make their own history. Something that's been expected of LeBron James ever since he was a teenager growing up in Akron, Ohio.
LeBron James is the best high school basketball player I have ever seen, and he will be, without a doubt, the first pick in the draft.
The stars were aligned in 2003 when the team just 40 miles north was holding the winning lottery ticket.
It's amazing. You get a team that gets the number one pick in the year that the biggest prodigy ever is coming out of high school. He happens to be from up the road. And the city who's getting him has had this epic drought. He seemed at the time like the answer to all of their dreams.
Akron, Ohio is where I was made. I tattooed the area code on my arm. Every time you see my name, you know where I'm from. That's a big thing for me and for everybody that's in this city.
Rod to the hoop for the win! He's got it! You can't book this one to the Cavaliers!
When he came to Cleveland, the expectation was this was the guy whose abilities would lift the Cavaliers to winning a championship. The fact that he was from Akron was the icing on the cake. That was the perfect storm of expectation.
In his fourth pro season, James imposed his will, carrying Cleveland further than they had ever gone before.
He has scored 22 of the Cavaliers' last 23. The Cleveland Cavaliers have knocked off the Detroit Pistons, and they are headed to the NBA Finals.
Although the Cavs would get swept by the San Antonio Spurs, it seemed apparent that this was simply the beginning of greater things to come.
2007, we got to the finals. It was almost like, this was easy. I mean, we're going to do this every year.
But that's not what unfolded, despite being considered by many to be the best player on the planet.
For the win, yes! LeBron James!
The Cavaliers would be eliminated from the playoffs in each of the next 3 seasons.
And Cleveland fans wondering if that's the last time he'll take off a Cavalier jersey.
And that's when LeBron headed off to South Florida to write his next chapter.
Look out, here comes James.
The Miami Heat would advance to the NBA Finals in their first season with LeBron on board. While in Cleveland, it was back to the drawing board and another first overall pick in the draft.
I'm the guy after LeBron. as expected to lead a franchise at 19 years old. The foundation was being laid down, though.
In that same draft that brought dynamic point guard Kyrie Irving into the fold,
Kyrie-diculous!
The Cavaliers also selected Tristan Thompson, a mobile power forward with a relentless motor.
Good hustle inside.
That's what he can do.
If the groundwork for revival was being put in place, it was not immediately reflected in the results.
The Cavaliers came out flat again, and it's just been that type of year.
When LeBron left Cleveland, Ohio, when we went into a rebuilding phase, it was very difficult.
For me and Kyrie, going through those tough times where we were a doormat of the league, we're, you know, the bottom of the East, it built our character and it kept us hungry as young guys.
But for the Clevelanders waiting patiently for this next generation to come of age, each successive postseason provided a painful reminder of what might have been.
LeBron James earns his second ring as the Heat repeat.
Yet no amount of success in South Beach could change the fact that at his core, LeBron James would always be a kid from Northeast Ohio.
LeBron is nostalgic about where he's from. He's sentimental about it. He'd still talk about what a parade would look like in Cleveland. And I don't think he ever really lost that connection to Northeast Ohio.
We're on the west side of Akron now, where I spend a lot of my time at.
You hear bits and pieces. Maybe LeBron really is interested in coming home. I went to Miami, I met with him, and we talked 15 minutes about the past, and literally in another 2.5 hours just about the future.
Once again, LeBron James would attempt to change the course of Cleveland sports history. And this time, he'd only need 3 words.
The words were, "I'm coming home." You heard about people checking their phones and just screaming, you know, when they saw this. There aren't that many athletes that have such a seismic influence. All of a sudden, a team that's an also-ran becomes the championship favorite.
South Beach, yeah! Go, Cavs! Let's go!
2 years ago, I set out a goal. When I decided to come back, and I'm now at this point in my career, it's championship or bust.
I'ma do what makes my city and my state happy, and that's why I came back. I love you, I'm back.
The king had returned, sending shockwaves through the sports world, but it would hardly be the last surprise of that summer. Having already selected Andrew Wiggins with the first pick of the 2014 NBA draft, the Cavaliers quickly packaged him up to Minnesota in exchange for one of the league's premier players, Kevin Love.
Love!
Got it!
On paper, the Cavaliers looked like a championship contender, but they were still anxious to prove it on the floor.
It started Labor Day. LeBron sends a text, "Everyone, come in and let's work out." And as a young guy, we feel like if we get in 30 minutes before, you know, I'm doing my job. But he's in there an hour before, full drenched sweat. I was like, wow, they're not joking around with this guy. This guy is the real deal. And I think Kyrie would say the same thing. It's like, we have no excuse not to keep working on our game and working hard. We got to do double the load.
Whenever we get an offensive rebound like that, if it ain't quick, I'm going to be spacing for that open.
As LeBron's new running mate, more responsibility would have to be placed upon the shoulders of Kyrie Irving.
In order for us to reach our potential, myself and Kyrie have to take full responsibility for the team and everybody else to follow.
Top LeBron James, welcome home!
And if not, our dream of winning a championship would not happen.
Together, they would help secure the top seed in the 2015 Eastern Conference playoffs. But cruel fate would conspire against Cleveland once more, as it had done so many times before.
Love hurt himself?
Yes, he did.
His shoulder popped out.
After losing Kevin Love in the first round, the Cavaliers would battle all the way to the NBA Finals. But they could not distance themselves from the inevitable bad breaks that haunted the city.
And now you see Irving showing how much pain he's in.
Despite a historic effort by James,
taken away by James. Here's LeBron to the basket, dunks it with the right hand.
The Cavs would go down to defeat in 6 games and would join the long list of teams from Cleveland that had come up short in their quest for a crown.
This city desperate for their first major sports championship in over five decades. It has now been 51 years.
Training camp opened prior to the 2015-16 NBA season. The Cleveland Cavaliers came back hungrier than ever.
Everyone remembered that feeling. Another team celebrating on our home court.
I got first, bro. I got first.
And it gave us that extra motivation all summer. The whole thing was unfinished business.
Go to work.
In the summertime, you know, I'm FaceTiming Kev, and when I looked in his eyes and he looked at me in the eyes, you can see that we knew what we wanted to accomplish.
The home opener for LeBron James and the Cavaliers. Of course, there's one goal for James and his team, and that's to win an NBA title.
Together on three. One, two, three, together.
Get going right away. Don't wait.
There's Love drawing the foul on Collison and hits it.
Although Kyrie Irving remained sidelined for the first 2 months, the defending conference champions raced out to the best record in the East.
Big time bucket by the Kings.
You're right.
Upon Irving's return, all of their pieces appeared to be in place.
Irving mesmerizing to the hole.
Yet something was still missing.
I felt like we got off to a decent start. And along the way, I think we sort of started to think maybe we were better than we really were.
In marquee matchups against the league's upper echelon, the results were all too often underwhelming.
The Toronto Raptors are gonna come away with this victory.
We had lots of times where, yeah, we'd play the elite teams and we'd struggle.
The San Antonio Spurs defeat the Cleveland Cavaliers.
It was just frustrating.
Merry Christmas to the Warriors as they knock off the Cavaliers in a rematch of last year's finals.
I knew we weren't as good as we needed to be. We weren't ready for the challenges that I know that's gonna come upon us, you know, once April and May hit.
132-98 final, Warriors dismantle the Cavaliers.
Losing to Golden State at home by, you know, 30-odd points, you know, it was embarrassing.
Cavaliers head to the locker room quickly.
Golden State went into Cleveland and obliterated them. And that's just like, you guys aren't real. Golden State's locked in. They're going for history here. What are you guys going for? You guys don't look like you're going for anything.
We had a disconnectedness. Something was missing, and there was a feeling that maybe we weren't quite squeezing everything we had out of the group we assembled.
In a move that stunned many observers outside of the organization, the 30-11 Cavaliers would make the critical decision to pass the reins and promote lead assistant to Ron Lue, who would assume the duties as their new head coach.
Ty presented a lot of the things we needed in terms of swagger, in terms of bravado, and maybe finding who we really were.
A veteran of 11 NBA seasons, Lue was known as a high-energy, hard-nosed competitor. He had been a part of two NBA championships and had been teammates with several of the game's all-time greats.
Michael skipping outside.
T. Lue firing and hitting.
Cleveland's new coach was not afraid to challenge his new team by insisting they go back to the basics before they could go forward.
Let's make sure we're talking, make sure we sprint to the elbow, make sure we get out. One stop, we're breaking.
Craziest thing about T. Lue was having a coach come in mid-season and telling you that you're out of shape.
Come on, man. Come on, Locke. Come on. Let's get it. Come on. Come on, we gotta figure it out.
People are thinking this is February. Guys are in shape by now.
Come on, fellas, keep it up.
He's like, no, we need to push the pace a little bit more. Guys are not in shape to do it right now.
There we go, keep it going. Let's go.
That first 2 weeks after he took over, we were just running up and down at practice.
Come on, strong finish.
And really trying to get everyone used to that faster tempo.
It brought a little extra life to the team. And it was a really good thing for us.
Good job, fellas.
The former point guard was also well-versed in communicating what was needed, especially with his lead ball handler.
T. Lou has a presence about himself, and he's comfortable in his own skin, so it's easy to follow someone like that.
Keep attacking, all right? Nah, come on, be aggressive, all right?
Irving gets the moves and Oz!
Oh, my goodness gracious, did you just see Kyrie Irving?
Offensively, I just wanted Kyrie to be aggressive and attack.
Kyrie flips up and out, and he's fouled!
So we had that talk, and I just had to constantly stay on him.
Let's go! Let's go, Kyrie! Let's go!
Behind the back, which way did he go? Bruising ankles, and he goes for three!
He stayed on Kyrie. And I think being a point guard himself at his playing days, he knew in order for us to be ultimately successful that Kyrie had to be the floor general. And that was very important.
Irving drives, gets inside, count it, and one.
Physical conditioning was no longer an issue, but the gnawing anxiety over mental lapses remained.
And the Cavaliers losing here tonight to the Heat in decisive fashion.
The way they beat us is a little concerning. It's not about the win or loss, it's how you win or lose.
Brooklyn takes down the best in the East.
The Brooklyn loss hit me pretty hard. I thought we should have been better. And I just decided to have a talk with the guys.
He just got on us about, listen, in order for us to reach our potential, myself, Kyrie, and Kev have to take full responsibility for the team.
He was saying that I had to just demand more of myself and also demand more of my teammates and actually be more vocal out there for my guys.
I told Kevin, you could tell LeBron or Kyrie, listen, I'm open, get me the ball. We want you to be aggressive and get back to being a top 10 player in this league.
Everything that we needed to get done and accomplish was all put out into the open.
The urgency of Lou's message was unmistakable. The impact and the immediate results were undeniable.
James passes out to Kevin Love. Kevin Love. Got it!
Let's go, Matt. Keep fighting. Here we go.
Kyrie calls out the play. A screen from Love. Cut. LeBron! Back door. That was beautifully drawn up.
The big three has been tremendous.
They're all on the same page. Wow.
With the land's big three finally clicking, the rest of the team fell in right behind, and the squad would hit its stride.
Cut it out. It's not fair right now. Everybody having fun.
Here we go. Here we go. Matt, keep getting stops. Keep running.
That's intercepted by Jefferson. Now come the Cavs. 5-on-3. LeBron behind his back to Thompson. Puts it up. Gets fouled. He scores.
Once guys started to see the effort combined with our talent and our ability, I think it clicked in our minds. Like, hey, you know what? Let's unlock our potential.
They're very unselfish. They understand movement, and the passes will be there if you're open. J.R. Smith. He squares. He shoots a three. He knocks it down.
Hey, way to move the basketball, all right? We keep moving the ball like that, we get shots all day.
Since he took over, Coach Lou has pumped on ball movement, man movement, when everyone is involved.
Around the horn. Break back to Dilley. Beautiful basketball.
That's basketball.
That's how you play today.
We're really able to take off and become the team that we were supposed to be.
This team is as focused and locked in as I've ever seen.
J.R. Smith driving. Handing. Ball! Wine and gold winner. As you're looking at the number one seed and home court advantage throughout the playoffs in the East.
The first order of business in the 2016 postseason was a familiar foe, the young and physical Detroit Pistons.
We worked all season long. We got to show up and do what we do best. Once the playoffs started, we got it going. We got it going right from the first round against Detroit.
Dellavedova turned the corner. Oh, it's LeBron! LeBron game! All of the emotion to go with it.
The Pistons would battle, but were no match for the vastly more experienced top seed in the East.
Dellavedova finds Irving for three. Oh, he puts it in! Kyrie Irving nails it.
It was a great test for us. I think the physicality in that first round and playing us close every game really prepared us for the rest of the playoffs.
Cavaliers win. They sweep the Detroit Pistons.
You did a hell of a job.
No, I'm telling you.
At the end of the day, let's enjoy this and know we got something else big we're looking for, all right? Come on, man.
1, 2, 3.
All right, here.
4, 5, 6.
We're here now. This is what we've been waiting for. We had an 8-day layoff, so we're ready to go. Coach gave us a great game plan, and it's up to us to execute. So it's time for us to go do it.
Next up were the Atlanta Hawks, who found out that the Cavaliers' offense could put up points in bunches and from just about anywhere.
Each series provided us an opportunity to do something different. The Atlanta series brought to the fore our ability to space the court and shoot. It was an amazing series from that standpoint.
Somebody's three, it's Fry again! Channing Fry! What a night, what an addition!
The Cavaliers have set the all-time NBA record for threes in a game with 25 on the evening.
I gotta give Griff a lot of credit putting together a very well-balanced team that has a lot of different components that can beat you.
For Kevin Love, whose first playoff run was cut short after just 4 games, this series was meaningful for him in more ways than one.
Just getting a little taste of the playoffs last year and having it take away from me so quick, I didn't take it for granted. I wanted to go out there and try to impose my will, be assertive.
This is what makes the Cleveland Cavaliers a dangerous, dangerous team. This Kevin Love.
LeBron feeds Love right side. He fakes the three. Got Cephalosha in the air. Appeared to get fouled. He did, and he knocks it down. Kevin Love. He has tied a franchise record for most threes in a playoff game with 8.
The Cavaliers have swept Atlanta for the 2nd straight year, and Northeast Ohio's going to host the conference finals again as the Cleveland Cavaliers have gone through the first 2 rounds without a loss.
I know these guys have been waiting for this opportunity again after what happened last year. And obviously I can't say that I haven't waited for them as well.
With a trip to the NBA Finals at stake, it was the Toronto Raptors who stood in the way, a team that had taken 2 of the 3 regular season meetings.
Have a great one, boy. Let's go.
Back to LeBron. LeBron has to track it down left corner, blows past Carroll. Oh, he put it back. Oh, my God. And it gets fouled. Oh, my.
Riding an 8-game postseason winning streak, there were no signs of a letup.
Here come the Cavs. Kyrie Irving behind the back at the top of the lane and skates down the right side to lay it in.
And this one, the largest playoff win in franchise history, 115-84.
The demolition continued as the Cavs won their first 2 games of this series by a total of 50 points, making quite an impression along the way.
How you feeling? Looking good. Things looking good for you, too. Go ahead and take that.
Yes, sir. All right. Yes, sir.
The postseason winning streak was at 10 in a row. But after stumbling in Game 3 to go down to defeat at a raucous Air Canada Center, the visitors were treated no better 2 nights later.
Toronto Raptors take Game 4 to even the series at 2.
We could have played much better, and I think it showed that, hey, you got to bring it every night. This is the Eastern Conference Finals. They're not going to come here and lay down. And they tested us.
Faced with a hint of adversity for the first time in the postseason, this Cleveland team would respond with force and would play with a renewed sense of purpose.
Kyrie Irving with a steal, 3-on-1. Alley-oop to James. Beautifully executed.
Believe it, Cleveland. The Cavaliers for the 2nd straight season have punched their ticket to the NBA Finals, and now only 4 wins separate this team from forever altering the course of Cleveland sports history.
I just want to say how proud I am of y'all, man. Don't ever let nobody take the pride of the game away from you. It's not promised. And we're fortunate enough to be one of 30 teams to move on to the next round. All right?
Yes, sir.
This is what you want to accomplish, but we're not done yet. Just one more step to our ultimate goal.
See you at the finals.
Once again, the Cavaliers would be facing the Golden State Warriors, the team who had beaten Cleveland in the 2015 NBA Finals and had defended their title in spectacular fashion.
73 wins, taking their place in the annals of the NBA with the greatest regular season record of all time.
This was the season of the Warriors. This was the season of Steph Curry.
Stephen Curry! You are amazing. MVP.
the unanimous MVP. And the greatest playoff comeback in Golden State Warriors history ends with a Game 7 win.
There's no doubt that LeBron was hearing all of that.
And it's back to the finals.
And there was an eye on Oakland.
Deep down, it was only right that we got an opportunity to play Golden State after what happened last year. Me personally, I wanted to see Golden State again.
All season long, the Cavaliers had been motivated by their unfinished business with the Warriors. They headed west at full strength, intent upon settling the score.
Game one, NBA Finals. That's what it's all about, man.
It's a hostile crowd. They're at home and they want to win both games. It's not going to be easy.
Enjoy every moment, enjoy the atmosphere, every second, every minute, every play, every possession. Enjoy it, all right?
An epic series begins tonight with game one.
Iguodala guarding LeBron James. James, the spin move, boy, makes it look so easy.
That was pretty.
That's 6'8", 270 doing that as well.
Green chest pass, high left side to Curry, working on Thompson. Thompson slips.
Curry the mismatch. Curry the three.
Good!
That's all it takes.
They're going to make some shots. That's okay. Just stay with it. Keep being aggressive. Keep attacking.
But a two-possession game at the end of three quarters would get away as Golden State turned up their intensity.
And Iguodala stole it again. Three on two. Curry in the middle. Klay Thompson running and laying it up and in.
We go play against the defending champions who had just won a Game 7, and we had just breezed through the Eastern Conference.
They out toughen us right now. They out scrapping us. Make no mistake about it. We got to be tougher.
We just hadn't played in that type of intense moment against that high level of an opponent. We weren't ready for that.
Livingston to the foul line, rises again. Good!
Warriors take Game 1, courtesy of their bench.
You lose the first game at Golden State, I don't think it was shocking. We had not played for a while, and I think we had a little bit of rust. For us to lose the second game in the manner that we did, I think was very disappointing for everybody.
Out to Green, tries another three, puts it! Warriors pouring it on, and they'll take a 2-0 lead in these NBA Finals.
And the Warriors have set a new NBA record. They have outscored the Cavaliers by 48 in the first two.
They got beat up, they got pumped, they got embarrassed.
We got to be better at all facets of the game, both offensively and defensively, both physically and mentally. Just got to do a better job.
When the scene shifted back east for game three, the time for tough talk had passed.
How many words we talked about? Ain't about words, about going to get it done. That's all that matters.
And if there was a message to be delivered, it was blunt and direct.
Do your job, man. Follow my lead from the start to the finish, all right? I got it.
Let's go!
Go get him, Tristan. Go get him.
Tristan Thompson back to LeBron.
Run down the lane. Took a feed from Tristan Thompson. Reverses one home.
This is a different basketball team than in games one and two.
Game one and two, we were like, okay, those are done. That's not us. Let's just get back to what we know.
Irving for three.
Game three, on.
Pucks it in! Kyrie Irving from way downtown! The Cavs have responded.
Stakes a three, fires a three, nails a three!
I think we felt like we needed to win, like oxygen, like, we're suffocating.
Jump! Switch! Jump! Jump! Switch! Hey! Switch! Switch! You're coming out that way! Switch!
James keeps his dribble somehow.
And now loose ball. LeBron James up with it. Passes over to Irving. Lob back to James.
LeBron's action spoke volumes about his drive to end the drought.
Back to LeBron! And LeBron hammers it home!
And that will do it. The Cavaliers claim game three by 30 points.
Very special, man.
Yes, sir. You too, man.
True professional game tonight, man. We needed everything that showed up in the box score and everything that didn't show up in the box score. It's big time.
Climbing back into the series with a much-needed win, the home team picked up right where they had left off in game four.
J.R. Smith misses the shot. Rebound, James. Passes out to Kevin Love. Love squares. Love shoots a three. Love knocks it down. Golden State trailing by five. And we're at the break.
We got to play faster. Be on the attack. Be the aggressor all night, all right? I don't care if we make some mess ups in transition, but we got to attack them, all right? Come on.
Just over five and a half remaining. This one has been close throughout.
James goes up, stripped. Oh, what a play by Andre.
What they do a great job of is if you make mistakes, they make you pay.
Inside, blocked by Bogut.
If you do it right, they still might make you pay.
Draymond takes it all the way, feeds Klay Thompson. He's open for three, and he buries it. Klay with a triple.
Hey, listen, we're killing ourselves. We got to communicate tough. We can't give them baskets.
We were up by eight in the second half.
Iguodala to Thompson out to Curry. Three-pointer, puts it in. Golden State up three, an 11-point turnaround.
We let game four go away.
The Golden State Warriors take a commanding 3-1 lead.
We went the whole playoffs without losing a game on our home floor. That one kind of stung.
Cleveland fans had been tormented for more than 50 years. And to make matters worse, no team had ever rebounded from a 3-1 deficit at the NBA Finals.
Are the Cavs done?
I don't even know why that's a question. Their chances of winning this series is zero, as far as I'm concerned.
Everybody is saying that we can't get this done and it's over. No team has ever come back from 3-1. But I was just calm. I started just automatically thinking about how we can be better for game five. I sent every guy a text that night and told him, don't listen to nobody right now besides the 14 guys in the locker room, the coaching staff. Let's make history.
Two most important days of your life is when you were born and when you discovered the reason why you were born. I think we're born to be champions. All right, we got a tough road to conquer, but we can do it.
The Cavaliers need a win to keep hope alive and force a game six back home in Cleveland. The Warriors are chasing history tonight, but they'll have to do it without Draymond Green.
Thompson way outside. Bang! Thompson long distance again. 26 first half points.
Facing elimination, Cleveland began to play their most inspired basketball.
Curry on the break. He goes up in traffic. Rejected by LeBron James.
The 12-time NBA All-Star routinely shined under the game's brightest lights. But for Kyrie Irving, it was the moment he had been groomed for, now coming to life.
Kyrie Irving throws up a left-hand layup. It's up and good.
Myself and Kyrie, we were just laser sharp.
He understood that I'm ready to be that guy with you. All I need is guidance when it's needed and then also freedom when it's needed.
Irving now looks to go left baseline, gets to the paint. Bang! Scores! Gets fouled by Klay Thompson!
It's one of the greatest performances offensively I've ever seen in the finals by Kyrie Irving.
And James would feed off the young floor general's energy.
James steps back. He tries another three.
That's good!
There was no panic in LeBron and Kyrie.
Kind of realize that something special is happening. And with those guys, especially in the second half, they were just not going to let us lose. It was unbelievable.
LeBron accelerates. Pump fake got hit, puts it up. He puts it in! And James has a chance for the three-point play.
It's the first time ever teammates had 40 points in a finals game.
What Kai did was so, so big. He announced to the world well before that he was a force to be reckoned with. But when you can put up 41 points against the defending champions in an elimination game on their home floor with one of the greatest players of all time,
it was the difference.
That was special. That will go down in the all-time greatest performances in finals history by my point guard. He was spectacular tonight.
Listen, we came here, took care of business. That's how we gotta fight, man. When we scrap, when we play hard, ain't nobody beat us.
We live to fight another day. We live to fight another day.
It feels great. A win or go home situation, just being resilient. But we're still down in the series. We understand that we're still playing against an incredible team. We gotta come out even better in game six.
The series stood at 3-2, heading back to Cleveland. The championship hopes were still alive.
To welcome back the Cleveland Cavaliers!
This whole state, this whole city, the whole community, everybody's behind them, and we just want to come out and let them know we believe and we're ready for game six.
Let's go, Cavs! Let's go, Cavs! Let's go, Cavs!
This is our time. You know, I know that having to win 3 games in a row is a tough thing to do, but it's Cleveland. Nothing comes easy.
After the other night, man, it gave us hope again, especially coming back home.
It's the biggest game in Cleveland Cavaliers history. A win tonight means the quest for the city's first ever NBA title is still alive. And the Warriors are looking to make some history of their own. They're one win away from capping their amazing season with a championship repeat.
All in, baby, we got it tonight.
Go Cavs, go Cavs, go Cavs.
This crowd is gonna have our back. They're gonna be, you know, out of their minds us coming home and having a game six to force it to a game seven.
The Cavs were still facing elimination, but they were back home and a renewed optimism was in the air.
Irving fakes. Drives, James on the throwdown. James left side, picked up by Azealing. Great pass to Thompson. Thompson cracks it home. Precisely the start the Cavaliers were looking for. Out comes LeBron James. LeBron lobs to the rim to Thompson. Oh, what a catch, and oh, what a dunk by Thompson off a brilliant LeBron James feed. Tristan Thompson with a double-double here in the first half. Energy in the building, energy on the floor.
We got so many great contributions. You know, Mo Williams, who hadn't played much, came in, gave us a spark.
Williams holding his balance, the floater.
And obviously, Dante Jones gave us a huge spark in the second quarter when some of our guys got in foul trouble.
Richard Jefferson had 3 fouls, and Amon had 3 fouls, and Tilo was looking for somebody to put in.
On the pick, Curry falls down. James finds a cutter as Dante Jones goes up in traffic. Good, and a foul.
Just true professionals, man, for us to be able to have guys that didn't play all year round that can come into a playoff game and a finals game and make an impact like that.
And the Warriors' time will be down 16 at the break.
I like our physicality. I like what we're doing. We got to keep it up. Make sure we keep our pace up, all right?
In the third quarter, the momentum would shift.
Handoff play, pump fake, fires a three, got it, Klay Thompson, nailed it down the left sideline.
Trying to come back here in the third, 5 to shoot for Klay Thompson. Thompson fires away, Klay Thompson coming alive, and it's a 9-point game.
But LeBron James was made for moments like these.
He doesn't get enough credit for being such a basketball mind. He's one of those guys that has a knack for knowing something's gonna happen before it comes. He knows every team's plays, he knows different lineups and switches and, you know, guys' tendencies. I've really never seen anything like it.
How come the Cavaliers' long lead pass to Smith? He'll dump back to LeBron! Oh, LeBron touches on the alley-oop!
Every time Golden State crept a little closer, the 4-time NBA Most Valuable Player would respond with a big play.
Draymond goes up, block. What a block by James.
Making a statement on both sides of the floor.
Attack, all right? Everything we got for 4 minutes. Come on, man, let's go. Come on. Let's go.
James had led all players in virtually every major statistical category throughout the series. And fittingly, he continued to dominate in the waning moments of Game 6.
James, offensive rebound, back up and in.
He's one of the best players ever. The more pressure you put on his shoulder, the better he's gonna play.
This once-in-a-generation player having another epic playoff game.
With his back against the wall, LeBron James poured in back-to-back 41-point outbursts, becoming the fifth player in NBA Finals history to score 40 or more in consecutive games.
James, finishing touches on a magnificent performance. And there's the buzzer. Game 7, Sunday night in Oakland.
He is just the epitome of what a basketball player is supposed to be. He plays a game in every facet. He plays defense, he plays offense, he gets people involved. He makes extra plays, he dives for loose balls. It's rare that you find a player with his skill level that's gonna do anything necessary to win.
Confronted with a decisive Game 7, the defending champion still felt that they were in the driver's seat.
I feel like we could have closed it out a long time ago, but here we are. It's tied up 3-3 and we're gonna be going back home, so if you told us to be in your season one game to win the championship in Oakland, we'll take that any day of the week.
For Cleveland, just one more win stood between them and the region's first professional championship in more than 50 years. They had never been closer to a title, but they still had to finish the job. The Cavaliers would have to be all in and embrace the moment.
Two of the greatest words in the world is Game 7. I've never stepped foot in March Madness where it's just one game and you're done. Or one game you win it all, it's like that feeling, it's like one game.
Welcome to the 19th Game 7 in NBA history.
Will tonight be the very night that Cleveland fans have spent decades dreaming about?
To be on someone else's home floor, to be around the adversity and the animosity and the crowd of someone else's fan base. And it's just you and your 14 guys and your coaching staff. There's no better atmosphere than that.
This is a Game 7 in the NBA Finals. This might be once in a lifetime. Leave everything out on the floor. Right, if we do that, we're going to give ourselves a great chance to leave out of here with our dream, all right?
Whatever happens, man, it's been a hell of a series. You guys have done a great job. All right, good luck. All right.
Oracle Arena is alive and roaring as we get set for Game 7.
Irving, he's bested by Klay Thompson. Pulls up 15-footer. Tough shot by Irving. That's a heck of a shot right there. Smith, pass right through the hands of Curry. Curry had that steal, but it slipped through his hand. James, the two-handed slam.
The intensity of the back-and-forth action would exceed the hype in this most hotly contested game of the series.
Green for three. Bang!
And Draymond's wide open, takes another three, 5 for 5.
Wow, think he's feeling it?
Makes his quick move, stops underneath, layup is good.
Draymond Green has 21 points, and the Golden State Warriors will go to the locker room with a 7-point lead.
We gotta be better, we gotta pick our body language up, all right? We gotta play harder. We gotta be more aggressive, all right? And listen, man, everything we got is 24 minutes, man. Everything we got.
We welcome you back inside Oracle Arena. We are underway in the third quarter. 10 to shoot. LeBron shuffles to his left. Gives J.R. Smith for a contested three. He's got it.
Good start here in the third for the Cavaliers.
There we go. That's how we fight. That's how we fight. Let's keep going hard, all right?
Outside of J.R. sidestep, Thompson for three. Got it. J.R. Smith, a heat check. Back-to-back threes.
Hey, Carr. You got to be aggressive. Come on.
Out comes Irving to the foul line. Works it on Draymond Green. Gets fouled. Puts it up there. Puts it in.
Entire NBA season coming down to one final quarter to decide a champion.
12 minutes, man. 12 minutes. Everything we put into the season, 12 minutes left.
Curry, crossover, three-pointer. It's good! Steph Curry from way downtown, and we're tied again. We've had 20 lead changes and 11 ties.
It was like Ali and Frazier.
Iguodala looks to go baseline on Jefferson. Jefferson cuts him off. Now it's Barbosa who drives for the left wing side. LeBron came back and said no once again.
LeBron drives on Curry by him, gets to the rim, blocked by Iguodala.
Oh my goodness, it's like it's playing with your mind so much.
Late in the fourth quarter, nearly 4 minutes passed with the score deadlocked at 89, when Golden State appeared to race off toward the go-ahead basket.
It was a two-on-one fast break, and probably 99.9% of the time that's going to be a finish between Steph and Iguodala. And JR was back.
Iguodala out of the pack. He's got numbers if he hurries. The Curry bounce pass, Andre.
My main thing was I knew Brown was coming, but just to give him a chance.
I was just like, I can't give up on this play. We've come so far.
Iguodala to Curry, back to Iguodala. Up for the layup. Oh, blocked by James. LeBron James with the rejection.
James out of nowhere skies to the rim. He bats it away.
Huge, huge defensive play by the four-time MVP.
Man, that was so big.
Game 7 was still tied, and the title was still up for grabs.
What about Kyrie Irving or LeBron James? The offense is running through me right now.
This is a journey I was preparing for my whole life. I had to be ready for it.
60 seconds to go. We're tied at 89. Here we go. Irving between the circles, down to our left. Irving's picked up by Steph Curry. Six to shoot. He's at the right point. He stutter steps. He launches a three.
Kyrie get the biggest shot that I ever seen or ever been a part of in my career.
One of the biggest shots in NBA history, knocking that three down with under a minute to go. Kid's good, he's good.
Now clinging to a three-point lead, the season to believe came down to a final possession. Everybody in the building sensed that if the Cleveland Cavaliers were to make history, they'd still have to stop Stephen Curry. Perhaps the league's greatest shooter.
He's made so many great shots throughout the entire season for them, which was a historic season, especially at home.
92-89, 52 seconds remaining.
I got switched out on to Steph, and I knew he was going to give me everything that he had in his bag. I knew that if I was able to stay down and stay in front of him, that I could, you know, really force him into a tough, contested shot. He gave the ball up after giving me a few crossovers, a few moves, and not being able to get a shot off. Draymond passed it back to him.
Curry fakes the three, steps back, crossover, puts up a three. Rebound, James. It's over. The Cavaliers are NBA champions. Cleveland is a city of champions once again. The drought is over. The curse destroyed. 52 years of torment and anguish has been washed away.
It's like, oh my God. To be able to accomplish something like that with a group of guys that you genuinely care about and genuinely love, there's no better feeling in the world.
We're done. We're done. We did it. We did it.
We got a group of guys that want to keep playing, and we believe in each other. Cleveland, we did it. We did it, Cleveland.
You worked so hard your whole life as a little kid preparing. It means everything to be a champion. It was tears of joy and a lot of emotion. Everything just hit me at once.
To be able to do it in a city like Cleveland, for everything that we do around here in Northeast Ohio is earned and not given. We work for everything. So when you're able to accomplish that, it's like,
Cleveland! This is for you!
And we did it all together. It's no better feeling than that. Especially no better feeling than doing it here.
This group, an
congratulations. You're the first team in the history of the NBA to come back from a 3-1 deficit. And LeBron, most valuable player, 2016 NBA Finals. Congratulations.
Hey, yo, put those number ones up.
People said we couldn't do it. Showed a lot of perseverance and resilience.
There's nothing quite like the bond that we'll always have together, and knowing that you're an NBA champion, it's just, it's surreal.
Feels good, and it only feels good, frankly, because of all the hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of Cleveland folks, and be part of the franchise that took that burden off of them after over half a century. I mean, to me, that's what feels the best.
There's no greater accomplishment in my book than that ultimate victory, and that's that team championship.
And this was our inspiration throughout the whole playoffs. We had 16 puzzle pieces to complete the whole puzzle.
What better way to inspire our teammates to come together to chase an ultimate prize than to make each guy an individual piece of the championship puzzle?
15 puzzle pieces for all 15 guys that made sacrifices. And the last puzzle piece, go to Coach Lou. Yeah!
Lost words. All I know is we're the 2016 NBA World Champions.
For the NBA's new champions, the only thing left to do was to bring the trophy back home so they could share it with Cleveland and all of Cavs Nation.
Shut the city shut down.
You're estimating over a million.
This was the hungriest fan base I've ever been a part of in my life.
I don't think I've ever seen something as beautiful as that trophy. So, man, this is why we play.
Let's go! Whoa!
We can finally say, we did it. Like, this is it. I really just started to believe we're champions.
That's the only thing you take with you when you leave this game, is championship memories.
First and foremost, I want to thank all of you for your incredible support. There are no fans or no people like Cleveland, Ohio. And let's keep the winning going. Thank you all.
Hello, Cleveland. I just want to thank the best fans in the world, the most passionate, most dedicated fans in the world. We did it, baby!
There are generations of fans, and there are future generations of fans that will define their lives by what the Cleveland Cavaliers did in 2016.
Anybody feel like a champion today? The shot, the drive, the fumble, all must now be replaced by the block, the three, and the D.
You guys would not let us lose, and you know, we got the ultimate prize.
And this is an unbelievable ride that I'll remember for the rest of my life. And the only question that can ever be said about this team is, what's next?
What's going on right now is still so surreal to me. It still hasn't hit me what actually happened. I'm nothing without the city. I'm nothing without y'all. I love all of y'all, and we get ready for next year.